This class we discuss about arc furnaces. There are three type of arc furnaces. One is a direct arc furnace, indirect arc furnace, submerged arc furnace. And before going to the subject, we should know some important terms. What is meant by arc? What are the types of electrodes used? What is the principle of arc furnace? What is meant by electric arc? When a high voltage is applied across the air gap, the air in the gap gets ionized under the influence of electrostatic forces and becomes a conducting medium. Current flow is in the form of a continuous spark called the arc. What is the principle of arc furnace? An arc can also be produced by short circuiting the two electrodes momentarily and then withdrawing them back. In this method of striking an arc, high voltage is not required. Arc drawn between two electrodes produces heat and has a temperature between 1000 degrees centigrade to 3500 degrees centigrade depending upon the material of the electrode used. What are the types of electrodes? Number 1, carbon electrode. Number 2, graphite electrode. Number 3, self-baking electrode. Carbon electrodes are made of anthracite coal and coke, which are used with the small furnaces for manufacture of ferroalloys, aluminium, calcium carbide, phosphorus, etc. Graphite electrodes are obtained by heating the carbon electrode to a very high temperature. Self-baking electrodes are made of special paste whose consumption depends upon the type of process for which they are used, contained in thin steel cylinder. The flow of current produces heat and the paste is baked and formed into an electrode, which are employed in ferroalloys and electrochemical furnaces and in electrolytic production of aluminium. Most commonly used electrodes are carbon and graphite electrodes with a size of diameter of 18 cm to 27 cm and are possessing the following properties. Number 1, good electrical conductivity. Number 2, insolubility. Number 3, infusibility. Number 4, chemical inertness. Number 5, good mechanical strength. And number 6, resistance to thermal shock. What is meant by thermal shock? Thermal shock is a variation in temperature which causes tension in a material. Now we'll see the comparison of carbon and graphite electrode. Number 1, carbon electrodes are amorphous. That means no definite form or shape. Number 2, graphite electrodes are obtained by heating carbon electrodes to a very high temperature. Hence, impurities in the carbon electrodes are volatilized. What is meant by volatilized? Cause to pass off in a vapor. 3. Specific resistance is lower in graphite electrode than that of carbon. Hence, the size of the graphite electrode will be half of that of carbon for the same resistance. This leads to easy replacement and the lighter control mechanism can be used compared to carbon electrodes. Number 4. Size of carbon electrode is higher than that of graphite electrode for the same conductivity and therefore larger area of charge in contact with the electrode. This results in uniform distribution of heat. Number 5. The life of refractory lining will be affected due to the arc being brought near the side of the furnace because of bigger size of carbon electrode. Number 6. Temperature exceeds 600 degrees centigrade, the oxidation of electrodes start and consumption of carbon electrodes begin. Number 7. The amount of graphite electrode consumed is about half of carbon for the same work. Number 8. Carbon electrodes are cheap and cost less than one half as much for same weight as graphite electrodes. Furnace is a device used for high temperature heating. The name derives from Greek word phornos, which means oven. So this is a single phase direct arc furnace. This is a three phase direct arc furnace. This is a chamber. This is a melting chamber. In single phase we are using two electrodes, or we can use a DC supply. In three phase we are using three electrodes which are connected in start. As the arc in direct contact with the charge, and the heat is produced by the current flowing through the charge itself, the direct arc furnace gives high temperature. The direct arc furnace consists of circular steel line inside with the refractory material. The top cover or a roof is removable and span is kept ready for replacement. Holes are provided. Here the holes are provided on the cover through which the electrodes are inserted. Adiabatic regulators are also provided in the furnace to insert the electrode in a desired length. Electrodes may be of carbon or graphite. The arc chamber consists of a suitable acid, a ground ganister mix or basic magnetite mix refractory lining supported on a metal framework. In this furnace, acid process is mainly for steel castings. The heating is through radiation only. Temperature 1500 degrees centigrade to 2000 degrees centigrade can be obtained. This furnace is suitable for high speed steel which are used for tool bits. Voltage between steel and electrode may be of 40 to 415 volts. In three phase, the voltage applied varies between 6.6 kV to 20 kV. The arc is controlled by varying the applied voltage, or by varying the arc length, or by varying the arc resistance. Its operating power factor is 0.8 lagging, and for 1 ton furnace about 200 kW is required. About 1000 kWh per ton energy is consumed for melting steel. Its capacity varies from 5 to 10 tons. The main advantage of direct arc furnace is stirring action is inherent due to EMF setup by the current. This results in uniform heating. The main disadvantage of this furnace is due to higher cost, its use is restricted to refining than melting. The main application of this furnace is mainly employed for making high speed steel. Indirect arc furnace. This is the construction, steel shell, and this is two our electrodes. We are giving supply. This is a charge. This is the arc developed in between the two electrodes. Generally, this type of furnace is in cylindrical shape. Since the charge is heated due to radiation only, therefore the temperature is lower than that in direct arc furnace. Current does not flow through the charge, hence there is no inherent stirring action. The furnace requires rocking mechanism for stirring action. The another name of this furnace is rocking furnace. The electrodes are projected through this chamber at each end along the horizontal axis. Electric motors are also employed for rocking action. Rocking motion provides not only thorough mixing of the charge, it also increases furnace efficiency and also the life of refractory lining material. This construction limits the number of electrodes to two electrodes only used. This cannot be used for three phase supply. Power input can be regulated by adjusting the arc length by moving the electrodes. The power factor of indirect arc furnace is about 0.85 lagging. Lower overall production cost per ton of molten metal. Sound castings in thin and intricate designs can be produced. Metal losses due to oxidation and volatilization are quite low. The disadvantages are rocking mechanism is required for stirring action because there is no inherent stirring action. Number two, cost of this furnace is quite high. Applications are mainly employed for melting non-ferrous metals.
used in iron foundries where quantities of iron are required frequently.
Submerged arc furnace. In this furnace, arc is formed between the carbon electrodes and earth electrodes. It is in cylindrical shape. The earth is lined of magnesite, which becomes comparatively good electrical conductor when hot. Sometimes a conducting earth is used as electrode. The number of electrodes depends upon the supply, single phase or three phase, in which bottom being connected to the neutral. Holes are provided on the top cover through which the electrodes are inserted. The current from the top electrode passes through the arc to the charge and returns to the electrode at the bottom of the charge. By varying supply voltage or distance between two electrodes, power can be controlled. Charge between electrodes acts as a resistance, providing better heat distribution, and better mixing takes place in the furnace. Under short circuit condition, the current is limited by the charge itself. Its operating power factor is 0.8 lagging. The application of this furnace is suitable for manufacturing ferroalloys like ferrochrome and ferromanganese.